Well, next tonight, when Ali Golian saw on Facebook that a former colleague he hadn't seen in 5 years needed a kidney transplant, it took him just minutes to decide that he would offer one of his. Well, how could Sonia Leonardo refuse? After a raft of tests and scans, Ali was found to be a donor match. And less than 2 months ago, both checked into Guy's Hospital for the transplant to take place, and it's been a success. And I'm very happy to say that Ali and Sonia join me now. Both of you, thank you so much for coming in to talk to me about this. Ali, I've got to talk to you first. It took you minutes, or you kind of knew instantly. You said your heart wanted you to do this. But that's a pretty big decision to make, isn't it?
Yes, it was really easy, though, because I was also one of her students when I was studying radiography.
Okay.
And she was always really kind to me, and she was an excellent teacher.
Yeah.
And it was just like my heart told me to do it as soon as I know.
Yeah.
As soon as I found out.
So, Sonia, Ali gets in touch with you kind of out of nowhere on Facebook, and he sees that you've got flowers up on your page, and he asks you, you know, will you tell him, were you sick? You know, this is one.
Well,
tell him the story.
I was just starting dialysis.
Yeah.
And it was a very overwhelmed situation for me, emotional. And my sister wanted to put on Facebook some of her colleagues and my colleagues at King's College offered some flowers and cards. And I told her, you can put the flowers in the cards, but don't put my story. I don't want people to feel sorry for me. Meanwhile, he saw it and he texted me personally and he said, what's up? And I said, well, I have kidney failure and I started dialysis now. I had this since I was 25.
Yeah.
But he said, do you have a donor, live donor? I said, no, I'm on the waiting list. And
were you surprised that he just offered that quickly?
The world is shocked.
Shocked, yeah.
When you don't have anyone who offers, your own family, and you have a person you haven't seen for 5 years to say, I'll do it. It's a mix between emotional and shocked and surprise. I didn't think that he would go through it.
Yes.
But he never changed his mind.
Well, he did. And you're doing very well,
yes,
aren't you? We see you sitting here now less than 2 months later. But both of you are sharing this story, this remarkable story, for a very serious reason, aren't you? Because you want more donors to come forward, particularly kidney donors. Tell me why, Ali. What's the issue with that?
Because there's around 5,500 people on the transplant list at the moment in the UK, and I just want to raise awareness that there's all these misconceptions that you're not going to be able to live a normal life, and I can live perfectly fine with one kidney, and I could do everything I was doing before, and I just want more people to see that we're a living example, that it is okay and it's not as bad as it seems.
Well, listen, it's been great to see you both here and great to hear that you're doing well, Sonia. And I guess I don't really need to say that you're not going to leave it 5 years until the next time you see each other, aren't you? Listen, Ali and Sonia, thank you so much for coming in to talk to
me
this evening.
Thank you.
Thank you.